Hi, I'm Aisha. You are watching Educational Hub. A conceptual framework illustrates what you expect to find through your research. It defines the relevant variables for your study and maps out how they might relate to each other. First, we need to understand. What is conceptual framework? The simplest way to explain a conceptual framework is that it is a diagram representing the relationship of variables. However, the complete explanation of a conceptual framework is longer and requires more explanation. In other words, we can say, a conceptual framework is an analytical tool with several variations and contexts. It can be applied in different categories of work where an overall picture is needed. It is used to make conceptual distinctions and organize ideas. How to make a conceptual framework? Before you prepare your conceptual framework, you need to do the following things. 1. Choose your topic. As a researcher, there are many aspects of the world you can choose to investigate. However, the critical thing to consider is that not all the world's resources are available to us. Moreover, the research may also be time-bound. As such, one should choose a topic that they consider to be comprehensively achieved within the resources they have and within the allotted time. To have a clearer idea of the process of making a conceptual framework, let us try to make a concrete example of it. Background. I am a co-owner of a branch of Burger King. I am interested to know what affects the satisfaction of our customers. My goal is to know what specific parts of our business can influence our customers' experience. Step 2. Make your research question. The research question is a clear and arguable question, which is where your research will revolve. Your research question should be one that you are truly curious about to have a concise conceptual framework. For example, the research question I can formulate is, what affects customer satisfaction of Burger King? Step 3. Conduct a review of the literature. Some of the key things you should remember when doing the review of literature are that it should be connected to the topic. Synthesize the results of the publications you have read. And recognize the areas where there is a lack of information or insufficient evidence to prove the claim. Having a review of the literature narrows down what you will be putting in your conceptual framework. For example, I read up on different publications related to food establishments, specifically burger joints and customer satisfaction. From here, I can already have an idea of the variables I can pinpoint from those publications that have been proven to affect customer satisfaction.
Step 4. Choose your variables. It is vital that you only select the essential variables, as not all of them will be significant. As you must have read much scientific literature, you should be able to discern the important ones by this point. And when creating a conceptual framework in particular, even though you can choose all the variables in the world, it would be best not to, since too many variables in a conceptual framework will be confusing. For example, with all the books, scholarly articles, and research I have gone through, it can be determined that there are three main variables: food taste, speed of service, and staff performance. Customers are very much concerned with the taste of the product. The amount of time it takes to serve them also affects how pleased or displeased they are. Lastly, the performance of the staff that serves also affects their experience.
Step 5. Choose your relationships. Now that you have chosen your variables, you have to decide how these variables are related to one another. Given that you have already read much literature on your topic, you should already define how each of your variables is connected. This is especially important to note, as this will largely impact how your conceptual framework will look once you start making the diagram. For example, I was able to determine that the three variables, food taste, speed of service, and staff performance, are determining factors of customer satisfaction. Step 6. Create the conceptual framework. The final step is to illustrate the diagram. How you demonstrate the diagram will differ on a case-to-case basis. Still, generally, variable names have to be laid out clearly and put into rectangles. Variables have to be connected with lines and arrows, and the arrowheads will differ depending on the nature of the relationships. Single-head arrows are for one-directional relationships. Thank you for watching. I hope you can easily understand how to develop conceptual framework. Like, share and subscribe my channel for more informative videos about research.